boys and girls.
Oh, beautiful spear!
Sunshine's here to help you.
I've got a team of lawyers that'll be here that quick if need be to take care of anything you try to do.
You never know what's gonna happen next.
Coming up on this edition of SWF Wrestling, you will see the rematch. Champion Shane Morton will take on Mikey Dunn. Also in action is Petey St. Croix as he takes on one half of the Outlaws, Trenton Condrey. And our main event will be the Ringmaster versus the Sharp-Dressed Man, Lawrence. Ladies and gentlemen, get ready for some SWF action. And good day to everybody. Welcome back to SWF Wrestling at its finest, ladies and gentlemen. Trenton now in the ring with Petey St. Croix. Great crowd on hand here at SWF Wrestling as it is each and every Friday night at the SWF Arena. And Petey St. Croix has got Trenton over there in the ropes. Clean break. Trent seems to be arguing about the count there. And again, we welcome you to SWF Wrestling. Sure do enjoy bringing this to you each and every day on LightTube. And of course, anytime on SWFWrestling.net. Trenton now got Petey St. Croix backed up in a corner. Oh, thought it was going to be a clean break. But he got pushing. Petey now fighting back. Several elbows there. And now a kick to the gut. And Petey now got Trenton in an armbar. Big hit on the elbow there, and now a submission move by Petey St. Croix on Trenton. Got to thank our sponsors, ladies and gentlemen. Can't thank them enough, and we thank them throughout the program. And we'll be mentioning them coming up here in a little bit. Trying to go for an armbar there, but Petey ain't unable to do it. Does a kick and a big knee to the head of Trenton. Still doesn't go down, but over in the corner, Petey's going back and inside the turnbuckles there. Trenton now down. And Petey taking control of this match early on. Now up on the second rope. Referee, well, oh, Marcus there, of course. There we go again. Marcus Woodrow interfering in the match. You thought he would learn his lesson after being, oh, and a low blow. Come on, ref. You can't tell me you didn't see that. Oh, my, right in front of him, too. Marcus Woodrow the third over there. You'd think he would learn not to do that after being handcuffed to Doug Harrison 2 weeks ago. But now Trent in control of this match as he's taking over Petey St. Croix. Domino's Pizza, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't feel like cooking, how about a delicious Domino's Pizza? Call them here in Tullahoma. They'll deliver it right to your door. Delicious Domino's Pizza. Call them today. Trenton now picking up Petey St. Croix. Be sure to stay tuned. We've got Shane Morton defending his title coming up here in just a little bit. And an awesome main event for you folks. Trenton now got Petey in a corner. Big splash. You know he felt every single bit of that. You're not going to pin him like that, Trenton. Sorry. Two count only. You can't complain about that. You're not going to nonchalant pin these wrestlers here at the SWF and expect to get anywhere out of it. Oh, he goes right to the eyes. I'm sure he learned that at Woodrow Enterprises. And Petey St. Croix still in trouble over there at the ropes. Not a good place to be. Trenton now distracting the ref. Oh, I wonder what's going to happen here. Oh, my goodness. Right to the neck. Marcus Woodrow III taking that cane and just pounding it into the neck of Petey St. Croix. Trenton now still working on the eyes. Our referee over there having him a beer or something. I have no idea what he's doing. Over at the ropes now, Petey. Big clothesline. Almost took his head off. You're not going to pin him like that. Close. I'll give you that. But you're not going to pin him like that, Trenton. The In-N-Out Burrito. All kinds of great food, not just burritos, for you and your entire family on North Jackson Street in Tullahoma. Give them a call. In-N-Out Burrito. Tell them SWF sent you up there. They will take care of you. Big right hand sends Petey down. And a blatant chokehold. Of course, I guess that's legal in the referee's eyes. SWF wrestling action every Friday night. Bell time 6. Excuse me. Bell time 8. Doors open at 6. Trenton distracting the referee again. Wondering what's going on over there. Oh, and Marcus using the cane again. Huge slap. Oh, watch this. Watch this. Oh, referee's finally paying attention now. Of course, damage is already done. Kane slapped on the back of Petey St. Croix. Shane Morton, as you know, a fighting champion, is defending his title a lot here as of late. And Mikey Dunn now getting his chance to reclaim it. To the ropes now, try to go for another clothesline, and Petey now fighting back. Trenton taking a swing, then getting a big drop kick. And another drop kick by Petey St. Croix. Can we go for a third one? Yes. Oh, blocked by Trenton, and Petey goes down. Now to the ropes, here we go again. Up, jump over, and a big tap. 1, 2, 3. Petey St. Croix wins the match. Trenton, of course, can't believe that. Absolutely. Oh, now look at this. You sore, Lou. You lost fair and square in the middle of the dadgum ring, and now you're going to take it out on Petey? Well, at least Lee Condry ain't here to help out. Big right hand there. Petey goes down. Bell's ringing. Absolutely despicable. Marcus Woodrow III should be ashamed of himself and all of his wrestlers he brings. Of course, he comes over there with the cane. Anytime you face one of Marcus Woodrow's goons, it's automatically going to be 2-1. Well, it looks like they're done now, folks. And we're going to take us our first commercial break of the evening. And we'll be back. Stay with us.
Ask anybody in Tullahoma where they get their vehicle service, and they will say Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler. Why? Because at Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler, the job gets done right the first time and every time. Depend on Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler for oil changes, alignments, work on brakes, belts, custom exhaust, and of course, quality name brand tires. Speaking of tires, purchase 4 tires at Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler and get rotation, balance, flat repair, and nitrogen absolutely free. It's not surprising that Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler has been voted number 1 in customer satisfaction 5 years in a row. Check in with Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler for excellent prices on truck rentals from Penske. No appointment necessary. Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler, 732 North Jackson Street in Tullahoma.
Y'all come on down and get the service y'all like to come. Thank y'all.
Welcome to In-N-Out Burrito. Come in and check us out.
We have a variety of lunch specials for only $5.49 that includes quesadillas, tamales, lunch-sized nachos, fajitas, and ground beef tacos. Lunch specials include a drink.
We have a variety of meals for you and your family to enjoy.
We offer a full range of appetizers, including chips and salsa for only 99 cents.
The In-N-Out Burrito Express, 1406 North Jackson Street, Suite 500 in Tullahoma. Call in orders at 931-563-7864. Stop throwing your money away on a habit that is taking your life away. Switching to electronic vapor can greatly improve your health in numerous ways while being much easier on your pocketbook. Kim Hammond and Gina Hall own the Electric Smoke Vapor House, located at 322 South Anderson Street, and have personal knowledge how hard it is to quit smoking. They have on hand hundreds of fun flavors to choose from and everything you need to begin a much healthier you. The Electronic Smoke Vapor House is locally owned and their liquid is mixed in-house. The Electric Smoke Vapor House, 322 South Anderson Street in Tullahoma. Phone 931-454-2333. Put down the pack and call today.
And we're looking forward to this one, folks. The rematch between champion Shane Morton and Mikey Dunn. Of course, you've still got Marcus Woodrow III out there. Mikey Dunn being probably his main protege. And I gotta give Mikey credit now. He definitely knows his way around the ring, that's for sure. Mikey starting out early with a headlock on Shane Morton, the champion. Shane taking Mikey to the ropes. And a big block there. Good grief, that strut makes the fans here at SWF want to puke. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to invite you to stay tuned for our main event this evening. It's going to be a good one, folks. The High Flyer Ringmaster going one-on-one with a sharp-dressed man, Lawrence. That is guaranteed to be an excellent match this evening. Mikey Dunn, very, very confident. And a tie-up in the middle of the ring, and now Shane Morton with a headlock. Going to the ropes there, shoulder tackle. And Shane Morton giving old Mikey Dunn a little bit of his own medicine there. I definitely like it a lot better when Shane Morton does it. Mikey don't seem to care for it none, though. Let's talk about Mike's tired breaking muffler. Folks, those people out there, they know customer service. They know it better than anybody. And not only will they get the job done right, but they'll treat you right while you're doing it, and their prices are absolutely wonderful. So go by and check them out at Mike's Tire Brake and Muffler. Oil changes, brakes, custom exhaust, anything you could possibly want. They're on North Jackson Street in Tullahoma. Looks like it was going to be a clean break. Mikey Dunn, and now an arm drag in the middle of the ring, and we've got a submission hold on Mikey Dunn. Claiming a pull tight. Whoa, referee is actually making him break the hold because Mikey Dunn's claiming he pulled his tights. Referee's checking with the fans. Of course, I'm pretty sure the fans are going to stand behind Shane Morton. Mikey Dunn out of the ring, now coming back in. It looks like this match is again underway. Looks like Shane and Mikey over there arguing with a fan. Or at least Mikey is. And here we go again. Tie up in the middle of the ring. There you go, Mikey. Oh, he's claiming another tight pull. Marcus Woodrow over there checking on his main dude. Now, a lot more arguing going on outside the ring there between Mikey Dunn and some of the fans. Folks, I'm going to tell you something. If you don't like Marcus Woodrow III, if you don't like anybody that he brings out here, I definitely invite you to come out to the SWF Arena each and every Friday night. Hey, you pay your money, you come in the building, you can save, tell them whatever you want to tell them. You earn that privilege. Shane Morton was going for a tie. Oh my goodness. That'll stop a raging bull, my friend. Shane was now coming back with those right hands, hard right hands. Referee's telling him to open them up, open up his fist. Choking there on the ring. Shane Morton's down. Now look at this weasel. Of course, he's going with that cane. Absolutely unbelievable. I don't know why the referees ain't seeing this. I don't know why they can't just look at Marcus and know that if he's going to be outside the ring, you're going, well, okay, you know, well, he knows about it. Shane Morton now kicking, Mikey Dunn now kicking Shane Morton. And another blatant chokehold. SWF Wrestling brought to you by the Electric Smoke Vapor House on South Anderson Street. If you ever thought about quitting smoking, now it's time to go to Electric Smoke Vapor House. They have all kinds of, I'm talking thousands of fun flavors to choose from. They'll help you out at Electric Smoke Vapor House, South Anderson Street in Tullahoma. Shane Morton now laying down face up in the middle of the ring. That's not a good place to be for him. Mikey Dunn, no, he ain't going to get this pin. I'm going to tell you that right now. Oh, wait, they're reversing it on Mikey. 1-2, and he kicks out. I don't know. Big clothesline by Mikey Dunn. I have no idea why these wrestlers pin the others just so nonchalantly. They know they're not going to get the pin that way. Mikey Dunn wasting a whole lot of time going back for the cover. 1-2, and Shane's going to kick out of that. And Shane now being thrown outside the ring. Mikey distracting the referee. You know what's going to happen. Of course, there goes Marcus Woodrow beating Shane up with a cane. Now looks like he's choking him. Yeah, he sees the camera, knows he needs to get out of hindsight there. Now Shane Morton out there outside the ring. Looks like he's got some upper shoulder pain there. That could definitely hurt him here.
Back inside, Mikey. Get both of you here. Is this your hero? This your hero? 2.
Big right hand there. More arguing going on with the fans. That's your right, people. You pay to come in the arena, you tell them what you think of them. You don't like Mikey Dunn, let him know it. Mikey going in there to interrupt the count out. And still waylaying on Shane Morton. Big right hand. Possibly even knocked a tooth loose on that one. And finally, Shane Morton back in the ring with the help of Mikey Dunn. Cover, 1-2, and no. No, Marcus went down for the 3, but the referee definitely counted the 2.
5 minutes gone, 5 minutes.
And letting him know about it. Shane now going to the ropes. Ducking the clothesline, ducking an elbow. And here we go with a possible small package, 1-2, no. Mikey able to kick out of that. Big kick to the stomach and a right hand sends Shane Morton down. Referee warning Mikey to use that open hand. Okay, we need to put the Ric Flair thing behind us and focus on the championship, Mikey. And an elbow drop. 1-2. Shane able to kick out. Taking a lot of punishment from Mikey. And like I said, Mikey Dunn, well, he's going for another pin. This time hooking the leg, 1-2, and another kick out. Mikey Dunn, one of Marcus Woodrow III's most valuable players, for lack of a better term. Was the SWF heavyweight champion, and I've got to give him kudos, man. He's at home in that ring. He knows what he's doing. He's very, very dangerous. Shane Morton, Shane Morton, big kick to Mikey Dunn. Mikey definitely stunned. And slam. Didn't look like it made its mark, though. 1-2, and a kick out, yeah. Mikey attempted to slam Shane, but it didn't look like it made its mark. And Shane was able to kick out in time. And now another blatant chokehold using the ropes. Referee count, I guess he got to 4. and warn him to stay out of his dope. Okay. The only thing I gotta say about Mikey Dunn, I mean, he pays too much attention to the crowd. He's got a championship opportunity here, and granted, very, very well. I mean, he's doing very well. But he could have had this one in the bag if he just paid attention to Shane Morton instead of the crowd. And a classic example. But you know what? Again, you come to the SWF arena, if you think you can help Shane by trying to distract Mikey, well, that's perfectly legal. And it looks like the crowd is definitely doing their job and helping Shane today. Mikey unable to let it flow off his bag. Okay, now here comes some punches now by Mikey Dunn. Referee again warning to open the fist. I don't know how many warnings it takes. To the ropes now, Mikey goes, and a block, and a big right hand sends Mikey down, another right hand sends Mikey down, another right fist, Mikey is down. Now to the ropes, Shane Morton, big elbow, and he is calling for Tito Santana. There it is. For some reason, the name of the move just completely left me. And here we go. He's going for the high kick, bro. He's going for the high kick. Well, look at Marcus. Referee, it's time to take Marcus and put him out of the ring. He is stopping the match. And now Shane, he's got the cane. Well, where's it? David Metcalf. David Metcalf trying to get the Bulldog on that, but he hits him in the stomach. What in the world is David Metcalf doing out there? Referee did not see it. Shane with a big kick to the side of Mikey's face. This could be it. One, two, three. And Shane Morton still your SWF heavyweight champion. Mikey Dunn is seeing stars. David, I don't know what David is thinking. David is a referee. And he's putting himself in a dangerous, dangerous position. Referee there raising the hand to Shane Morton. Mikey Dunn being tended to by Marcus Woodrow III. I don't think Marcus realizes what happened. I think he realizes it was Metcalf. Well, obviously Mikey does. I don't think Marcus Woodrow knew it. Well, Metcalf obviously came and left. He's already gone. Mikey Dunn. I don't know about this, folks.
What happened, Mikey?
You tell me what happened.
I'll tell you what happened. We had him up there. I slid.
Yeah, sure you did. Yeah, yeah. Come on, we got to talk about this. Metcalf stuff is getting out of control.
Yeah, yeah.
Shut up!
You shut up!
Boy, I'm not.
Come on!
All right, ladies and gentlemen,
I guarantee you, it's another trick by the SWF against the Woodrow Enterprise, and I'm telling you, I'm getting sick of it. You just left.
Metcalf, man, what are you thinking, dude?
What do you mean, what am I thinking? What? Like, you know, and I told you this was not over, not by a long shot.
Welcome to In-N-Out Burrito. Come in and check us out.
We have a variety of lunch specials for only $5.49 that includes quesadillas, tamales, lunch-sized nachos, fajitas, and ground beef tacos. Lunch specials include a drink.
We have a variety of meals for you and your family to enjoy.
We offer a full range of appetizers, including chips and salsa for only 99 cents.
The In-N-Out Burrito Express, 1406 North Jackson Street, Suite 500 in Tullahoma. Call in orders at 931-563-7864.
Stop throwing your money away on a habit that is taking your life away. Switching to electronic vapor can greatly improve your health in numerous ways while being much easier on your pocketbook. Kim Hammond and Gina Hall own the Electric Smoke Vapor House, located at 322 South Anderson Street, and have personal knowledge how hard it is to quit smoking. They have on hand hundreds of fun flavors to choose from and everything you need to begin a much healthier you. The Electronic Smoke Vapor House is locally owned and their liquid is mixed in-house. The Electric Smoke Vapor House, 322 South Anderson Street in Tullahoma. Phone 931-454-2333. Put down the pack and call today.
Wait, Mikey. Wait a second.
Mikey. No, and I tell you, man, Metcalf just cost me the SWF heavyweight title.
I understand that. We had this all planned out, Mikey. I don't know what happened.
You told me that you had a plan with Shane Morton that I would get my hands back on that title.
Right, and I did have a plan.
Right, but you didn't think about David Metcalf. Where did this guy come from?
I don't know what Metcalf does, and this is beginning to tick me off. I'm telling you, every match we get screwed by some of the referees and Metcalf every time. I don't know where Metcalf came from this time.
Well, listen, I'll tell you one thing. What I want done is I want something done with Metcalf. I don't care who you got to bring in. I don't care. Just set it up with me. I don't care. But something's got to be done, and it's got to be done now.
I told you, I've got a plan, and I'm working on another one. It's clear that the first one didn't work. I'm coming up with something. You know, Mikey, you know how I am. I bring in the best wrestlers I can find. And I've got somebody in mind. I've got a wrestler in mind from overseas that I can bring in, and I'll take care of some business around this stinking place. And you will be champion once again. You'll be wearing that gold. I can promise you that.
All right, well, it needs to be done. And this Metcalf thing is getting on my nerves.
I'll handle the Metcalf thing. We'll get rid of Metcalf one way or the other.
Ask anybody in Tullahoma where they get their vehicle serviced, and they will say Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler. Why? Because at Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler, the job gets done right the first time and every time. Depend on Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler for oil changes, alignments, work on brakes, belts, custom exhaust, and of course, quality name brand tires. Speaking of tires, purchase 4 tires at Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler and get rotation, balance, flat repair, and nitrogen absolutely free. It's not surprising that Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler has been voted number one in customer satisfaction 5 years in a row. Check in with Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler for excellent prices on truck rentals from Penske. No appointment necessary. Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler, 732 North Jackson Street in Tullahoma.
Y'all come on down and get the service y'all like to come. Thank y'all.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our main event on SWF Wrestling, brought to you by Aaron's of Tullahoma and Manchester. For anything you need, appliances, furniture, you know, bad things happen to good people. They don't care about your credit. Aaron's, come on down and they will assist you in every way possible. Sharp-dressed man Lawrence. You know, let me tell you about this man right here. You can love him or you can hate him. And as you can tell, the people at SWF don't think a lot about him. Well, we're watching. Like I was saying, like it or not. Like it or not, sharp-dressed man Lawrence, definitely at home there in the ring. He is definitely a competitor that you just can't put down. He knows what he's doing. And if you are facing the sharp-dressed man Lawrence, you can't deny it. You're going to have to do a little bit of extra training
before you go to the ring.
Good professional wrestling. Wrestling, not wrestling. Professional wrestling. Here's the man you want to see. When I'm done with this guy, what is he called again?
I don't remember.
The Ringmaster.
Yeah.
Last week, I beat him down. This week, it's going to be the same thing. After you,
after you. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our main event. Marcus Woodrow III bringing again one of his most popular proteges, the sharp-dressed man Lawrence, good for speed. Excellent speed. And excellent agility. That is for sure. And now the music starting and the crowd getting up and ready for the entrance of the Ringmaster. You know, the Ringmaster, he's definitely been around too. I think wrestles mostly for the ASW up in Lewisburg. Has been in the business for a while, definitely is a competitor. Also, you're going to want to train extra hard on. I'm actually kind of a little concerned about his abilities as far as being able to beat Lawrence. And there he is, the Ringmaster, ladies and gentlemen, as we get started off with this main event, running right towards the camera. And the crowd here at the SWF loves the Ringmaster. And there he is.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing his opponent, the Ringmaster.
Definitely looking forward to this match, ladies and gentlemen. When I saw it on the card last week, I knew this was going to be main event material, and I am sure they are not going to disappoint. Again, Ringmaster, the up-and-comer, sharp-dressed man Lawrence, a veteran in the ring. And if you've never seen sharp-dressed Lawrence wrestle, you're definitely in for a treat. Like I said, love him or hate him, he definitely is at home in that ring. He knows exactly what he's doing, and you better be afraid of him if you know what's good for you. You definitely tell who the crowd is behind. And here we go. Bell is rung, and this one is underway. Ringmaster chases sharp-dressed man Lawrence out. Referee having to break him up.
That's my good ear.
Oh my goodness. As opposed to his bad ear.
So what are you saying?
You ain't got nothing to look up behind.
And here we go again. Still complaining about that ear pull. Ringmaster getting the crowd behind him. Not too awful hard to do here. They sure do love him here at the SWF. Here we go again. With Lawrence right now. Oh my goodness, Lawrence now. On the top rope, trying to get away from him. Well, I understand it's wrestling, but Ringmaster's ready to go, my friend. I mean, it's time to put up or shut up. I think it was a good friend of mine, Chaos Max Carnage, telling me, you're not baking cookies in that ring. You better be ready.
Right here, boy! Get you some of that!
Well, Lawrence now. Looks like it's going to be a test of strength here. I don't know if this is smart. I don't know if this is smart, Lawrence. He knows what he's doing there now. He knows what he's doing there. Oh, big kick to the gut. Ringmaster's down. Man, the pain that that must cause right there. Having your wrist just completely bent back. Well, now, wait a minute. Ringmaster's fighting back. But another kick to the gut puts him down. Wow. Ringmaster now obviously in a lot of pain, but he's fighting back. He is definitely fighting back. Here he comes now, and a step on the hand. Referee now forcing the ringmaster to back off. Well, maybe he needs to go to debit cards, because that hand's definitely going to be sore for a while. Ringmaster looks like he's got the psychological edge now on Lawrence. Back in the corner now. Probably not going to be a clean break. No, it's not. Goes for the punch. Ringmaster backs off. Had him in the corner. Obviously a clean break. Ringmaster backs off. And here we go again with another tie-up. Or no? Looks like another game of strength here. Lawrence now retreating over to his corner. Well, a corner. And Ringmaster again told to back up. Referee having to explain the rules to Ringmaster. Of course, now he understands and he knows what he's doing. But I mean, you're not going to be able to wrestle as long as Lawrence keeps tying himself up in the ropes. And now here we go again. Here we go, tie up now in the middle of the ring. And an arm bar. Ringmaster. Now taking control with a submission hold on the left arm of Lawrence.
Oh my goodness! He's breaking my thumb!
Feels like he's applying some pressure to that thumb. Oh my goodness! Man, I wouldn't be surprised if he done some damage to that elbow on that one. Marcus now tried to. And a bite! Ringmaster is biting the hand of Lawrence, denying it. Hey, don't be looking at my camera.
We got it on camera.
You ain't getting nothing on my camera, Marcus.
That's disqualification, is it not?
Marcus, you don't need to tell the ref how to do his job, my friend. I mean, he's got this. You ain't seeing my film.
I can't watch
a replay. There you go. All right, now Lawrence now working on the arm of Ringmaster down to a headlock, flipped over. And we've got a submission hold now. Looking for some hair. I don't think you're going to find any. No, or he's got him by the collar. No. Bids him away. Two. And we're back to the headlock there. Saying he's pulling on his pants. One, two. Another kick out by the ringmaster. What a match this is, folks. I'm telling you. You've got both fairly small competitors, not no heavyweights by no means, but they are definitely heavy contenders. Looks like Ringmaster is coming back out of this headlock.
10 minutes, Sean, 10 minutes.
Trying to find that. Ringmaster still looking for some hair there. You're not going to find it on him.
What do you say, Ringmaster?
Trying to see if he submits. He does not. Ringmaster, look at that. Look at the strength. Look at the strength of Ringmaster getting out of it. Was able to turn it around, and now Lawrence in the headlock. Overturn. Okay, now Ringmaster definitely got some hair. And okay. The pool. Marcus. Where is the Woodrow Enterprises anyway? I've heard different stories. Ringmaster turning around. Whoa, wow. Was able to come back and get a headlock. First, I want to remind you again, SWF Wrestling each and every Friday night. Tullahoma, Tennessee, 106 Southside Drive. Doors open at 6, bell time at 8. You want to be sure to come on in, $7 admission only. But come on in and tell Marcus Woodrow what you think of.
Have a mask.
Is that a mask or hair? I thought that was hair. But one. Ringmaster looks like he's complaining. No, tights. Thought he was complaining of camp. That might be a part of this mask. I thought it was his hair. Whoa. What was that? Oh, I see. Referee saw that he was in his tights before he was able to make the three count there. That was close. If he hadn't saw that, Lawrence would have been able to win this match illegally. Headlock still going on by the Ringmaster. Lawrence was able to get to his feet. Over to the corner now. What's going to happen here? I doubt it's going to be a clean break. No, of course not. Shoulder right into the gut of Ringmaster. And another one. What a match, folks. Back and forth, back and forth. Here he goes. Over to the corner. Big shoulder right into the gut of Ringmaster. Somebody get him a bucket. Holy cow. Unbelievable. Count now. Referee now just trying. Oh my goodness. Wow. Oh my goodness. Did you hear that? Did you hear that? The cane struck. It sounded like it hit his teeth. And now another chokehold on the Ringmaster. Now, did you hear that cane just slap against? I'm going to say it was his teeth. Sounded like it.
I got it now. Don't do so, Uncle Jesse.
Uncle Jesse. Oh my goodness. A desperation kick out there by the Ringmaster. How he's able to get up enough energy, I have no idea. Taking a major punishment now in the ring. Wait a minute, now Ringmaster trying to. No. Look at this. Standing on top of him.
Get off the ropes. That's what we like right here.
I wouldn't be surprised if Sharp Dressed Man Lawrence gets a title shot pretty soon. In my eyes, I mean, he's definitely earned it. Whether or not you like him or hate him, he's definitely seemed to have earned his shot for a title. Now another submission hold by Lawrence on the Ringmaster. Ringmaster trying to get some help from the crowd there.
He's out! Check him!
He might be out. I still see him. His eyes are open.
Hurry up! Shut up!
Of course, I don't know exactly how voluntary to know. He's coming back. He's coming back, and now he's got a foot on the rope. The hold must be broken. Well, now Marcus pushes it off.
Hey,
wow. Double arm axe handle on the lower back of the ringmaster. I don't know how much more punishment he's going to be able to take. Whip to the ropes now. Ducks the clothesline and a big elbow sends ringmaster back down, possibly in the area where he got hit by the cane. 1-2. You know that illegal object that the partner... Well, you better not do that. You better not do that. Better keep your hands off the referee. People have lost their paychecks, the fines, because of that. And now we're back down. Lawrence working. I tell you, this is what I'm talking about. See that he's working on the lower back in the chin area of the ringmaster. Chin area is where he got hit by the cane. And of course, the lower back is just what it is. At this point, anybody would not blame the ringmaster for giving up here. I mean, he's definitely fought the fight, okay? There's no shame in it. But somehow the ringmaster's getting back up, and he's got two elbows to the... Oh, my goodness! A knee to the midsection sends ringmaster back down. The boys got fight. I gotta say that. The boys got some fight in it. And now, is he actually... His fingers were actually on the inside sockets. Eye sockets of the ringmaster.
Get on him, Lawrence. Get on him, man.
Get up, punk!
I don't know what to say. It is absolutely amazing that the ringmaster keeps battling back from this. This is a punishment. Morris now over there spending time with the ref. Oh my goodness, right to the kidney. A kidney shot. A big punch now to the gut. Another kick. There ain't no shades of Grease Lightning. Stomps in the corner. I just don't know what to say. Ringmaster in just a lot of trouble. Taking a major punishment here. Marcus Woodrow probably, I'd say he's even taking mercy on the ringmaster, trying to say, put him away. Over in the corner. Wait a minute, here we go again. It's not over till it's over. Going again. Second row. Big elbow to the lower chin of the sharp-dressed man Lawrence, and now he is down. Ringmaster cannot capitalize. He can't. He has absolutely nothing left in him. How he was able to even do that amazes me. But now he doesn't even have the strength to capitalize. Lawrence back up. Well, ducking that hit. Big. Right hands. I heard that from all the way over here. Ray has several right hands on Lawrence. Going to the ropes now. Kick to the side of the face of Lawrence.
It's over.
Now he's dragging him in the middle of the ring. Can he possibly get the pin? 1-2. No. Ringmaster getting his second win. How in the world he's getting it, I have no idea. But here he goes on Lawrence. Elbow. Backhand. Going to the ropes now. Wait, got caught. And now, he got caught. And now we're back down in the submission hole. This could be it right here. This could be it. He's got his hand up there like he's about to tie up. Ringmaster, there's no shame. No, he's going for the ropes. He got that left foot on the ropes. He's got it, break it. Yeah, it's a submission hold. He's got to the count of five. He didn't tap. He put his foot on the rope, Marcus. Pay attention. Lawrence now going for the finisher. What is rematch is going to do? Oh, my goodness. And another. Where did he get one? Two. Marcus Woodrow calling for a disqualification because of he did not pull no tights. He just got clobbered.
Keep it down. Keep it down. Just a minute. It was clear, and I'm sure we got it on film somewhere that he pulled the tights.
I didn't see it. I did not see him pull the tights.
He got the tights as three times. It's pretty obvious to me that somebody has paid every day. What are you referees off?
Let me tell you something. All I was looking at was his shoulders on the mat, and I counted 1, 2, 3.
Do your job. Watch the whole thing.
How about you do your job, Marcus Woodrow, and just manage your wrestlers? There you go. In an amazing comeback to Ringmaster. Folks, we'll be right back. Stay with us on SWF Wrestling.
Stop throwing your money away on a habit that is taking your life away. Switching to electronic vapor can greatly improve your health in numerous ways while being much easier on your pocketbook. Kim Hammond and Gina Hall own the Electric Smoke Vapor House, located at 322 South Anderson Street, and have personal knowledge how hard it is to quit smoking. They have on hand hundreds of fun flavors to choose from and everything you need to begin a much healthier you. The Electronic Smoke Vapor House is locally owned and their liquid is mixed in-house. The Electric Smoke Vapor House, 322 South Anderson Street in Tullahoma. Phone 931-454-2333. Put down the pack and call today.
Ask anybody in Tullahoma where they get their vehicle serviced, and they will say Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler. Why? Because at Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler, the job gets done right the first time and every time. Depend on Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler for oil changes, alignments, work on brakes, belts, custom exhaust, and of course, quality name brand tires. Speaking of tires, purchase 4 tires at Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler and get rotation, balance, flat repair, and nitrogen absolutely free. It's not surprising that Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler has been voted number one in customer satisfaction 5 years in a row. Check in with Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler for excellent prices on truck rentals from Penske. No appointment necessary. Mike's Tire, Brake, and Muffler, 732 North Jackson Street in Tullahoma.
Y'all come on down and get the service y'all like to come. Thank y'all.
Welcome to In-N-Out Burrito. Come in and check us out.
We have a variety of lunch specials for only $5.49 that includes quesadillas, tamales, lunch size nachos, fajitas, and ground beef tacos. Lunch specials include a drink.
We have a variety of meals for you and your family to enjoy.
We offer a full range of appetizers, including chips and salsa for only 99 cents.
The In-N-Out Burrito Express, 1406 North Jackson Street, Suite 500 in Tullahoma. Call in orders at 931-563-7864.
Martial Law Files tonight.
With the what?
The Martial Law File.
No, I don't like the X-Files.
You know, like Crocodile Hunter. You
what the hell's a Crocodile Hunter got to do with the Martial Law Files?
Okay, you just follow my lead. You don't talk. Tonight, mates, we're going to be looking for that great American mythological legend, the Great White Jack. If you notice, mates, we're all covered in camouflage. And by the way, diet sun-drop. Other states don't get it.
Now, this thing lives in carnivorous areas, right?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Like, it's like he can eat things Smedley. We're safe. He can't eat us.
He doesn't eat humans.
Just like Smedley. He won't eat us. We'll protect you, mates. Now, listen, children. You don't try this at home, mates. Let's go look, see if we can find this.
Okay, now, where does he usually hang out?
It's like he's usually he's like a restaurant show. Yeah, mate. Let's go see if we can find him. Come on. Look, can you get a shot? You can barely see it in the darkness. Can you see it? It's got the trademark mohawk. It's got all the hallmarks of being a great white jack.
What's he doing?
I don't know. It could be mating season.
Nobody's ever seen this before.
Let's get a little bit closer. Can you get closer?
Is this safe? Because, I mean, if he's, like, hungry or something.
Oh, it'll be okay. Just trust me. I know what I am a professional, kids. Don't try this at home. Let's get a little bit closer. If you'll notice, hey, over here, dude, if you'll notice it, it's got a snake going to it.
What the hell?
Boy, that's a beauty, mate. Look at that beauty. Listen, children, that's a rare look at the elusive great white jack. Now, I know
800 pounds. 800 pounds.
It's humongous. I know that sounds like babble to y'all, but that's really the mating call of the great white jack. Now, if we may get to witness something rare here.
Look, we're over here talking about snakes right now. Y'all just...
You see?
This ain't got nothing to do with you.
Let's go. Come here. Bring it over. Let's look. Boy, that's a beauty, mate. That is a beauty.
What the hell?
Check out that gut. That is gorgeous, mate.
Look,
and the marks on it. Wait a minute. Let me get this.
Who cares? Look, that is a beauty. The children don't try this on.
What do you mean?
Don't worry, Stacy. You can't see it. It's okay. We got camera.
What the heck? You think you're stupid?
Look at this, mate. That is a beauty. That is a beauty, mate. Don't try this at home.
Get back.
Don't try to antagonize it. It's obvious it's ready.
I'm hiding behind you, cameraman.
It's obvious it's ready for mating, and we don't want to disturb it. That is a beaut, mate.
See, you wonder why we're laughing stock because you're a bunch of idiots.
Look, see, it's mad now. Look. We have disturbed its mating ritual.
I hope he doesn't charge. Smaller,
that's the female mate. And it's got his snake because they do a little ritual with it. And really, we can't say it because it's too graphic. Even though they do show naked chicks on the internet, we can't show
it. We don't even talk about the naked chicks.
Well, I like talking about naked chicks, mate.
What about the great white jack?
Oh, put that light back on. Look at it. That is a beauty, mate. Look at this. You'll notice the red tinges in its hair. You'll see them. Look at them arms on it. Don't get too close, mate. Only a professional should do this. There it is. Look at that.
Shut up, you moron.
Come on, Jack.
See, they're going to mate. They're going to mate.
Let's go back.
We better not disturb them when they mate. Now, children, boys
and
girls.
That was dangerous.
That was.
That was dangerous.
But that was awesome. We have seen nature at work. People, you have just witnessed the first ever caught on film, rare glimpse of the mating ritual of the great white jack.
That will make history. We're going to be on the Today Show.
Oh, we'll be on the Discovery Channel. That's
all. Discovery Channel?
Yeah, like on when they like hunt for monsters and things like that. You know what I'm talking about? Like them real shows.
We're going to make some money.
We'll get rich. Children, do not try this at home. Only a professional should ever, ever approach a great white jack.
Ain't that right, Smedley? Never mind.
Nah, you go talk. Have a good one, mate. Till the next time. Peace out.
Boys and girls.
Oh, beautiful spear! You need your head over there.
Sunshine's here to help you.
I've got a team of lawyers that'll be here that quick if need be to take care of anything you try to do.
You never know what's gonna happen next.